Let's look at this question. Gopal borrows rupees X from Ankit at 8% annual interest. He then adds rupees Y of his own money and lends rupees X plus Y to Ishan at 10% annual interest. Okay. At the end of the year, after returning Ankit's dues, the net interest retained by Gopal is the same as that accrued to Ankit. Okay. On the other hand, had he lent Gopal rupees X plus 2Y to Ishan at 10%, then the net interest retained by him would have increased by 150 if all the interests are compounded annually. Find the value of X plus 1. Now, while reading this, look at this wording. If all the interests are compounded annually, who cares? Because they are only giving me data about 1 year. So this is irrelevant to the question. Compound interest has nothing to do with the question. Now see, previously when he was extending X plus Y at 10% annual interest rate, and later on he was extending X plus 2Y at 10% annual interest rate, his interest amount has increased by 150. The principal has increased by Y and the interest amount has increased by 150. Can I say 150 is 10% of Y, or Y is equal to 1500? Y is equal to 1500. Wonderful. So now I know Y. The Y amount I know. Let's look at X. The interest earned by Gopal would be 8% of X. And this is equal to 2% of interest earned. See, because Ishan has forwarded it the same X amount at 10% interest, he is gaining additional 2% interest on X. So 2% of X plus 150, 10% of Y. Y is 1500, so 10% of Y will be 150. So you get 6% of X is equal to 150. Or X is equal to 150 into 100 by 6, cancel 2500. You have 2500 here, you have 1500 here. Then therefore the value of X plus Y will turn out to be 4000, and that is your answer. Careful reading of the fact that the principal here has increased by Y, and therefore the interest has increased by 150, helps you identify the value of Y fairly quickly.